Champions. Isn't it true that it feels good to have champions in our life? In every movie we like, there is a good chance that we immediately recognize and identify with a champion. But also in real life, we all have champions, right? Let us try to prove it to you. We are going to show you an image and ask you to choose who your champion is based on that image. But you have only 3 seconds, so think fast. Here we go. Who is your champion based on this image? Did you pick Michael Jordan? In that case, you are probably with most basketball fans. I give you another image and 3 seconds to choose your next champion. Who is your champion? Was it Michael Phelps? Or another one of the first class swimmers in the world? In any case, you have your champion. We all can search in our brain's database and find one person that fits in the category of champion for any given topic, area, sport, or science. But it's much harder sometimes. What about if I ask you to find your champion for the sciences of the brain? Can you find someone who you can consider your winner when it comes to the study of the brain, the most important organ of our human existence? Take 3 seconds. Who? Anyone? Could you find anybody? Well, in case you don't have one, may I suggest one champion of the brain in this video? Let's do it. Today, we have a clear question. Who is the champion of behavioral neuroscience? I tell you, this one is not an easy question to answer. First of all, we have to remember that this is a matter of personal choice. And second, it is not so easy to pick a champion in a field with so much talent. Just to give you the names of a few of the many giants that we can identify in the field of neuroscience, here are some. Charrington, Skinner, Pavlov, Penfield, Olds. These are just a few of the ones we are planning to cover in our future videos, because they deserve it. But I promise to give you one name for a champion, and I will keep my promise. Before we announce our winner for the position of champion of behavioral neuroscience, a couple of disclaimers. Number one, this is only our opinion, but it is shared by many other scientists. Number two, we have no time to go in depth, but I think we will give you enough elements to justify our pick. And number three, find relevant links in the description below, which we recommend you to check. Okay, are you ready? And the winner is Santiago Ramon y Cajal. Based on what we claim, he is the one. Okay, step by step. In behavioral neuroscience, we seek to understand how the brain creates and controls behavior. A huge territory to explore. But everything starts with this question. What is the brain? No one knew exactly what the brain was made of in the 19th century. You know, the little details. Until Cajal's works, the scientific community thought that the brain was a dense network of connected nerve cells, something like a diffuse mass. In 1888, the Spanish researcher, or should we say the Spanish giant, then a professor at the University of Barcelona, demonstrated the individuality of each cell, the neurons, and that the transmission of nerve impulses to communicate those neurons was done by contiguity, not by continuity. He called the contacts between neurons kisses. Now we know them as synapses. And he did most of such transcendent research here. And with here, I mean in these times, the 1800s, everybody, in these conditions, with this equipment. How could you, Cajal? How could you? Even in these conditions, he would make poetry about his daily adventure. And I quote, like the entomologist on the hunt for butterflies of colorful nuances, my attention pursued in the garden of gray matter, cells of delicate and elegant shapes, the mysterious butterflies of the soul. But then he had to show the world his neurons, and Nikon was not invented yet, and Canon was also not around. Hey, Nikon and Canon, unacceptable. But Cajal had his art. He could draw like few. Take a look at this magnificent neuron. I bet right here, right now, that you and I can't draw this neuron even if we are given a whole week. And what would you say about this one? Holy buckets, did you see that? That is not even a simple drawing. That's a whole composition to show neuronal circuits in the brain. Let us show you two more. Hey, Bobby, can you help me here? Hey, my friend Bobby, guys. Impressive drawings. Thank you, Bobby. You can find many more of Cajal's drawings following the links in the description. The scientific work from Santiago Ramon y Cajal was so important that he received the Nobel Prize in 1906. If you didn't have your champion for behavioral neuroscience, I ask you to consider Cajal for your list. He deserves it. And if you want a little help to remember the name of the giant of the neuroscience, you can use this mnemonic, Santiago Ramon y Cajal, SRC, Science Righteous Champion. Guys, a little help with mnemonics, acronyms, or poetry is welcome. Do you also have a poet side like Cajal? Would you please leave your mnemonics, acronyms, or poems in the comments below this video? We will appreciate your words to help us all remember the name of Santiago Ramon y Cajal or the name of your champion of behavioral neuroscience, if he or she is a different one. Now, to choose Cajal as our champion, it could also help if we look outside science, just to be sure the guy is not a jerk in other departments. We already know that he was a great artist, but he was also a photographer. Remember, this picture's quality with no Nikon and no Canon around. In addition, many consider him as a champion chess player. And now some of you could go, such a nerd. Not so fast, guys. Cajal was a bodybuilder as well. Hey, definitely, that is not the average body of a scientist. And I prove it every day in the mirror. But Cajal was not a shallow bodybuilder. Listen to what he said about bodybuilding. Okay, here I quote, "Excessive muscle development in young people almost inevitably leads to violence and bullying. With the corporal energies, it happens what with the permanent armies. The nation that has forged the best warrior instrument always ends up trying it on the weaker nations." Not an easy guy, eh? I find it like there is only one last consideration here. What if he was a lonely man? That would be not so good, or? But again, not the case. Cajal was able to have a joyful family with 7 children and a very happy wife, Silveria Fañanás García. Who can beat that? Here you have it, Santiago Ramon y Cajal, an artist, photographer, bodybuilder, scientist, chess player, poet, and publisher, and an excellent father and husband. He is considered by most the father of modern neuroscience. And in case you didn't have your own, I hope you accept Cajal as our champion in behavioral neuroscience. If someone ever asks you, who is your champion in behavioral neuroscience? You should get that cool air of someone who knows what she or he is talking about and respond, Santiago Ramon y Cajal, who else? The next quote from Cajal defined who he was. In summary, all great work is the fruit of patience and perseverance, combined with tenacious concentration on a subject over a period of months or years. Let me finish with a final personal note. The School of Neuroscience in Spain is excellent, and I am sure it is also because of Cajal's legacy. This is a photo of my young years when I was studying for my PhD in behavioral neuroscience with so many friends from all over Latin America and Spain. Most of my professors were from Spain, José María Delgado, Alberto Ferrús, and many others. Even when I didn't track it so far, I bet that I can build my tree of neuroscience knowledge all the way back to Cajal itself. So, Don Santiago Ramon y Cajal, way from the future, here goes my deepest gratitude. many, many, many things. Your teachings have undoubtedly changed my life for the better. Dear friends, my wish is that you stay safe and that God bless you.